She loves to watch every movie first day, first show. Very much like me actually. And अभी उन्हें उल्टा है, इसको फिल्म अच्छी नहीं लगती है. But when Meenakshi chose Sundareshwar, it was not first day, first show. It was an eighth day, eighth show. आठवां prospect था. And this movie is set, you know, बोलते हैं कि marriages are made in heaven. And I'm telling you, this marriage was made in the holy city of Madurai. So ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the cast of the movie. प्लीज वेलकम हमारे देश की एक ऐसी पर्सनैलिटी जो है दंगल और लूडो में वर्ल्ड चैंपियन सानिया मल्होत्रा. प्लीज एंड प्लीज गिव अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज टू सानिया मल्होत्रा. इस द मर्द जिसे दर्द नहीं होता पर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस शादी में रह के उससे बहुत दर्द हुआ. अभिमन्यु दसानी. हाय गाइस, यू आर लुकिंग लवली बोथ ऑफ यू.
थैंक यू सो मच अतुल. हेलो एवरीवन, सो गुड टू सी यू ऑल.
फिल्मों में दो लोग मिलते हैं फिर उसके बाद प्यार हो जाता है नहीं मानते और फिर एंड में मान जाते हैं. बट दिस इज नॉट दैट. आपकी मूवी इज नॉट दैट. तो जब आपने पहली बार ये स्क्रिप्ट सुना, व्हाट वर योर थॉट्स? सानिया,
I think just like Meenakshi, it was love at first sight. Because I remember Vivek narrated me the script, and मुझे तो प्यार हो गया था with Meenakshi and the whole world that Vivek and Harsh have created. So definitely a love at first sight. Just like Meenakshi.
This film, when I heard it first, it was again narrated by Vivek, very passionately narrated his story. I found it extremely unique, one of a kind, and at the same time super common. Like that mixture was just so fresh and amazing to me. I thought I have to be part of something that is so passionate and so different and common at the same time.
I'm so glad both of you are part of this amazing movie. You know, teaser mein maine ek line dekha hai, engineers don't give up easily. फिर वो चाहे इंजीनियरिंग हो या रिलेशनशिप. मैंने ऑलरेडी बताया मैं भी एक्चुअली इंजीनियर हूँ, मैं एग्री करता हूँ. फिर जब मैं अपने भाजी वाले से बार्गेन करता हूँ, आई डोंट गिव अप वेरी इजीली. आप दोनों के हिसाब से रिलेशनशिप में गिव अप ना करना कितना इम्पोर्टेंट होता है?
मेरी ना ही सुने तो बैठी हूँ पर मीनाक्षी के सुने तो आई थिंक बोथ मीनाक्षी एंड सुंदरेश्वर दे हैव लाइक अ लॉट ऑफ पेशेंस. तो वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है और कम्युनिकेशन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. तो बात करते रहे हम जिसके भी साथ हैं, मेक श्योर दैट यू आर लेटिंग देम नो कि आपको क्या पसंद है, क्या नहीं, क्या ठीक लग रहा है, क्या नहीं. तो दैट इज रियली रियली इंपॉर्टेंट.
कंपैशन एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग आर बेसिकली द बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑफ अ रिलेशनशिप. सो आई थिंक गिविंग द पर्सन टाइम एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड पेशेंस इन एनी रिलेशनशिप फॉर दैट मैटर एंड देन रिसीविंग दैट, इट्स जस्ट वंडरफुल.
Amazing. I think as you said, communication is the base of, you know, the relationship.
True.
अब अच्छा, जैसे देखो कैटरपिलर होता है ना, एक पॉइंट के बाद बटरफ्लाई बन जाता है. इंडियन पेरेंट्स के लिए भी जब भी बच्चे आफ्टर 20 हो जाते हैं ना, तो मैरिजेबल एज के हो जाते हैं. तो आपको भी कभी पर्सनल लाइफ अरेंज मैरिज का रिश्ता आया है?
नहीं, पर मैं सोच रही हूँ लेट माई पेरेंट्स नो, क्योंकि मेरे पेरेंट्स मुझे बिल्कुल फोर्स नहीं कर रहे हैं. तो मम्मी पापा अगर आप ये इंटरव्यू देख रहे हैं तो प्लीज करें.
पिछले दो तीन साल में काफी कोशिश की है.
मम्मी अगर आप ये देख रहे हैं तो सीखे.
अच्छा, तो किस डिस्टेंस के बाद लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस रिलेशनशिप को कंसीडर किया जाता है, जैसे अगर लड़की कोलाबा में है और यू नो लड़का बिहार में है,
एब्सोल्युटली दैट्स लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस।
आजकल बॉम्बे में तो यार कार बैंगलोर में भी लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस हो जाता है। बट होल्ड, अगर आप लोगों के अभी लाइफ में लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस रिलेशन में रहे हैं तो कैसा एक्सपीरियंस है? हैव यू बीन इन अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस रिलेशनशिप?
यस आई
हैव। ओके,
इट्स वेरी स्पेशल बट काफी मतलब आई डिडंट हैव दैट मच पेशेंस। मेरे मीनाक्षी जितना पेशेंस नहीं था मेरे में, इसलिए वो थे था थे बीइंग द कीवर्ड इन रिलेशनशिप में थे।
माइन वाज फन व्हाइल इट लास्टेड।
ओके, ही इज ऑलवेज वेरी पॉलिटिकली करेक्ट।
हां, अंदर की
बात ओपनिंग आता सारे लोग नहीं आता। बट बिफोर हम आगे बढ़े, यू नो हमारे बहुत से व्यूअर्स हैं, यू नो हु मस्ट बी कंसीडरिंग अरेंज मैरिज होपफुली, तो फर्स्ट मीटिंग्स में यू नो यूजुअली काफी ऑकवर्ड होते हैं, द बॉय एंड गर्ल मीट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम। इन योर ओपिनियन, सिंस यू हैव बीन थ्रू अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस अरेंजमेंट इन लाचेस सुंदरेश्वर, व्हाट शुड बी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन? आप फर्स्ट मीटिंग में गए हो, माँ बाप ने आपको अलग दे दिया, बेटा आप तो सुनने जाके सर साइड में जाके आप किससे बात करते हो, व्हाट वुड बी योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू आस्क योर प्रोस्पेक्टिव मेट?
Food is an important part of my life. I wake up, have breakfast, and then I'm already thinking about lunch. Kya khaunga uska chai pe kya pakega dinner. So then I definitely ask some questions about food. Yeah, veg ho ya non veg ho, khana banana aata hai ki nahi, khane se pyar hai ki nahi, are you passionate about eating? Because I sometimes even do a happy dance when the food is very nice.
Happy dance
to hota hai.
Aaj hum lunch ke baad dekhna chahte hain.
Bilkul bilkul, acha khana lagta hai.
But I think the veg non-veg question is very important, because otherwise always bill double ho jata hai, you know, and what will happen is
you can't even share the bill.
Ha, share
the bill nahi kar
sakte, khali roti share kar sakte,
but dono order karke apna apna bhi kha sakte hain, that is way better, to usme bhi share nahi karna padega.
But sharing is caring, jaise pyar badhta hai ek plate mein khane ka, ek hi all that.
So you can share tomato or kheera.
Sure.
What about you? What question would, what would you think? What's the first question you would ask your prospective
group? Movie देखना पसंद है कि नहीं?
हाँ, okay.
That's a very important question for me and Meenakshi both.
Yeah.
ये बहुत important question है कि आपको देखना पसंद है, बैठ के आप Netflix देख सकते हैं, नहीं देख सकते?
That's important.
वो मेरे साथ में choice नहीं. You have to enjoy movies. That's not a choice.
That's important. और क्या? एक one more. What else है? तो
देखो जैसे मैंने बोला मेरी मम्मी मुझे किसी के साथ भी सेट नहीं कर रही, तो मे बी वी शुड आस्क यू, आप क्या बताना चाहेंगे?
माय वाइफ डज नॉट स्नोर टू बी माय कैनॉट इट, आई कैनॉट हैंडल इट, दैट्स आई थिंक वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, पहले पूछना चाहिए, यू नो.
पर अच्छा,
शी इज नेवर फेस दैट प्रॉब्लम, शी इज नेवर फेस दैट.
आई एम प्रीटी अगेंस्ट ऑफ मैरिज, आई नेवर फेस. चलो मूविंग ऑन. Now we'll go to almost very short game we'll play. Okay? Can I ask the host to get some the cards? तो हम आपके साथ एक game खेलेंगे. बहुत simple है. आप दोनों को दो signboards दिया जाएगा, true false. Okay? I'm going to ask you questions about each other. If you say, I mean, both of you can answer the same time whether it's true or false. Can I have this? Yeah, please.
आपके
जिक्र तो अभिमन्यु को मम्मी से अपने डर लगता है?
लगता है क्या? मुझे नहीं पता, तुम बता।
ओ स्पेशली ब्रेकफास्ट टाइम पे जब ये वो प्रपोजल लाते हैं।
स्टिल लर्निंग वेज टू अवॉइड।
अच्छा सानिया इज अ बिट मनी अ बेटर डांसर देन यू।
He is a very good dancer, but he मानता नहीं है. He is very modest.
Sanya should be doing a dance film, guys. Directors, producers, writers, dance choreographers. She is probably the best dancing actor that we have.
Yeah, super dancer. Both of us.
Yeah, I would love her.
अच्छा अभिमन्यु अपनी सारी Netflix recommendations आपको बताता है.
हाँ बताते.
And Sanya also? Yes. Damn good. That was very good. Thank you so much. You did very, very well. Can you ask the host to come and take these very heavy true and false? Give it to me. Give it to me.
इसे हम वर्कआउट कर सकते हैं.
हाँ, actually, अभी मैं तो जब तक इसको दे बाइसेप्स कर लेता था. तो अभी हमारे साथ जुड़ने वाले हैं इस शिप के कैप्टन, the director of मीनाक्षी सुंदरेश्वर विवेक सोनी. Along with them, we have अपूर्व मेहता, producer and CEO, धर्मा Productions, producer and manager, धर्मादिक Entertainment. Soumen Mishra, Head of Fiction and Films at Dharmatic Entertainment and Co-Producer of Meenakshi Sundareshwar, and Ms. Pratiksha Rao, Director of Films and Licensing, Netflix India. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause to all these. How are you guys enjoying the live show? Meaning the trailer launch of Meenakshi is finally happening. Vivek, questions for you. ये आपकी पहली Vivek? Vivek, question for you. ये आपकी पहली feature film है.
जी.
It will soon be out there for the world to see. कैसा लगा? Very cliche question, but yes, and also important. What important day करता
है? First of all, thank you so much for coming for the event. Means a lot for us. आपका सवाल कैसा लग रहा है? बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है. Nervous, excited, confident. We have put in a soul and heart to the film, and I hope you guys like it and enjoy it.
I'm sure we will all. Thank you. You know, we rarely get to see Hindi films जो South में set हुई है. आपने इस film के लिए Madurai को ऐसा setting क्यों choose
किया? Well, the story. Organically itself, I feel kind of blends into the setting of Madurai because the film is called Meenakshi Sundareshwar, and the basic incident which kind of happens in the film, that the reason that both of them get married is because of that. The fact that both their first names make the famous temple of Madurai, so that is also there. And also, in order to make it visually stand out, that was the reason. And also, as you yourself said, that not often we see films are being set in South India. So it's always great to visually and visually explore that landscape which is not being built before much.
Yeah, and I've been to Madurai many times. It's such a beautiful city. Thank you for exploiting it and showing us the city from your point of view. Apurva, I have a question for you. You know, Dharma is a very special corner as usual for romantic drama, and this one is very much in the same in your arena. What attracts you to such projects?
So firstly, I have to say thank you everyone for being here. It's wonderful to see everyone. I think we have forgotten how these events are done, if we have been delayed anymore. And Karan is unfortunately, fortunately, he's shooting his next feature, so he sent his regards because he can't be here. Answering your question, I said, Dharma, we are really fortunate to have the opportunity of having dabbled across all genres, you know, be it a spy thriller, be it a war drama, a comedy, historical. But for us, love stories are the most special. I think that's what we're known for, and I think Karan and Soumin really understand the genre really, really strongly. And you know, love stories are language and culture agnostic. You know? So in that sense, and in these pandemic times, what would be better than having a really beautiful, entertaining love story that brings a smile to your face and lightens up your day?
Well said. So my next question for you. You know, aapne just first time this film ka script padha tha. So what really clicked for you?
You know, I have an honest confession to make about the script and the film. This is, I can say for a lot of films, this is one of those films where the film has become much better than the script, you know. Wow. So all kudos to Vivek and the team and the actors. And also about the love stories, you know, what has happened in the last few years in India, worldwide, we're not making love stories. If you think, you can't think of three love stories somebody has made. Because everything is tuned towards, you know, big ideas, novelty factor, which we are also doing, event films, biopics. So when the script came in, this was a love story, which is, you saw a love story post-marriage. So that was an interesting book. Plus, it's written very well, there's nice characters, setup, all those things were there. And but love story also depends on chemistry. Seeing, achha, will it translate on screen? Paper pe toh achha lag raha hai. So thankfully, all that thing has come in place. So the script was great, but the film is much better. I guess what I'm saying might sound alien right now, because nobody has seen the film except us. So hopefully you guys will watch the film. But that's why for us it's interesting to do a love story after a long time, you know. Even Dharma, we are not doing love stories. It's because, you know, the other genres have opened up and we are experimenting, yeah. Which everyone is doing worldwide too. So that's why we are very excited about it.
And I think especially the long distance arranged marriage, that concept is so, I think, new and unique. Pratiksha, next question for you. How does Netflix approach bringing romantic stories to Netflix? Like, how diverse is the rom-com genre becoming?
Thanks, Atul, for the question. Interesting fact for everyone. In 2020, we saw an increase by 250% of the viewing of romantic films and series in India. So that just tells you how much people are craving seeing love stories on the screens, and, you know, who better to partner with in telling a love story than Dharma? You know, they're very iconic. Each of us probably has a Dharma film that we kind of aspire, you know, when we think about our own romantic lives with. But for us, to be honest, it's really just about the story and how powerful that is. When it comes to romantic stories, is it giving you a window into someone else's love story? Is it an extension of your own imagination, expression of love? So those are the kind of thoughts that, you know, we keep in mind when we're looking at potential romantic stories. And this one is very special, very interesting, because as Vivek mentioned, there's a very beautiful and different setting that you haven't really seen in Hindi films before, but also it shows tradition, family, but then, you know, the young couples, their own individual aspirations. So I think it's something that a lot of us will relate with.
Thank you. But, you know, 200% jump in love.
250%.
I think because, you know, husbands are locked up with their wives the last 2 years. They had no option to love story. What can they do? But anyway guys, now it's time to go to Madurai and watch Meenakshi Sundaresh's trailer. Ladies and gentlemen, please let's watch the trailer for the very first time of Meenakshi Sundaresh.